In this video, we are going to review V0, which is an AI app builder that's been around for a little while, but I haven't tested it since it first came out. We're going to create real designs with V0 and compare it to other AI app builders like Base44 and Lovable that you might be familiar with. We're going to do a prompt to generate an optimized email newsletter landing page for daily AI updates for founders to stay up to date on all AI changes. Now, right off the bat, they have something called design systems. So you can select one of their default design systems or create a new one. I've selected Soft Pop here, and you can see it basically has this cool design. So I'm hoping that this is going to, just by default, improve the design and not just look like a standard AI-generated website. I sent it off, and now on the left side, we have our chat, and it's going to tell us what it's doing and generate the pages. And then on the right side, we have our preview, where we can both preview what the code looks like once it's generated. And then we also have this code mode where once the code is ready, we'll be able to see that code. It looks like we also have the ability to connect to our GitHub account, which is always really helpful so that we can move this code off of V0 and onto something else. You can share it, make it private, public, and then we can also publish it to the web, and we'll do that once we finish with our initial design. Then we also have some other features we're going to test out in a second, like design mode, and we have some prompt tools as well to enhance the prompt. Okay, and the first version is complete, and let's check it out. It's got a really nice design. I like how it wrote the copy as well. Overall, I'm honestly really impressed with the design. I think it did a really good job. It stuck to that design system, so it just looks really nice and coherent, and it doesn't have that same AI design that like every Lovable site or Base44 site has, for example. So I think that is really important and is actually a big differentiator in this space of AI design tools. So that's something I would definitely keep in mind when you are choosing a design tool that you want to use. Being able to customize the design with different themes, I think, is really helpful. It's really cool. It even generated this kind of like preview of what it looks like. So that's really cool. So let's see if I enter in an email, what happens. So right now, nothing happens. It looks like it didn't generate another page, although we can see what it looks like on different screen sizes. So let's see what it says. Say, can you generate a thank you page after people subscribe? So let's do that first. And then the next thing I'm going to do is investigate a little bit further of whether we can use this to actually store email addresses or connect to something to store email addresses, or what's the best way to do that with V0. Okay, so it says it created a thank you page. And if I click subscribe, it says no thank you page detected. Looks like there's an issue. Okay, so apparently it should be fixed now. Let's try it one more time. Let's see if we publish, if that is able to fix it somehow. Okay, so it says it's ready. So now we can at least view the site. And it really does look beautiful. I'm really impressed with the design that I'm seeing here. So overall, the design of this homepage is great. I'm really happy with it, but we are running into some issues. So let's see now if this will take us. Okay, so now it is working. I don't know what was happening. I'll check it again in the designer real quick, but now we have this thank you page, which looks great. And that's what I was hoping for. It even has a referral link. It built out a lot of things here on this thank you page, which I really like. So now let's go back. Let's just see if I refresh just to test if it's working in the designer now. I don't know why that's happening. Okay, and now it is working in the designer as well. So it's working in both. We just had to debug a little bit. The design itself, I think, looks amazing. I'm really happy with the design. So I did a little bit of research, and we definitely could take this design and turn it into a working app with a backend. The best way to do this would be to sync to GitHub, take this front end that we just created and then put it in something like Cursor, and then add the back end. You could use Supabase, you could use Neon, whatever back end you want to use, you would then add that and start building on top of it. So when you're building directly into V0, it's really primarily a front end tool, but then you could use what you've built here in the front end and then add it to add a back end in another tool. Overall, I'm really impressed with the design, and I think that it's smart that V0 is optimizing for being the best design tool. I think that the fact that it was able to take this style that we did in the beginning, and basically you can change this to other design systems. So just to show you like what Cosmic Knight looks like, for example, it looks like this. So you're going to get a different design system that's going to match what you want. You can also go and under design systems, do new design system and change everything about this to make it exactly what you want, to customize what all of your projects in V0 look like. So to me, the design system is the killer feature of V0. I wish they had more of them even for default design systems, because that would give us even more customizable designs that we could add. So that's one thing that I would say. I guess it would be nice if you could build the backend directly in, and maybe they'll add that in the future. But right now, just building the front end, I think, is enough for this tool. But if you need to have that backend integrated, you're going to need to use a tool like Base44 and Lovable. So that's the nuance there. If you just want design, I do think V0 is still a really great option. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. Leave a comment below. Let me know what you think, if this is something that you would use. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content like this, and we'll see you in the next video.